tanga, buro boya.
In 1940, American big bands were trying to play traditional Cuban music, but only Mario Bautza could make it happen. He decided to bring his brother-in-law from La Habana, Frank Grillo, known best as Machito. Machito played a huge role in the history of Latin jazz, as he became the first to use Afro-Cuban rhythms with jazz improvisation. Machito founded the Afro-Cubans band in 1940, the first jazz band to use trumpets and trombone, adding a new dialect to the vocabulary of jazz and creating something in between the American swing and the Afro-Cuban beat, getting Cuban music into the main street of America. This transformation of jazz wrote the beginning of sensational mambo that later became salsa music. By 1945, Puerto Ricans immigrated to America, seeking the American dream, followed by the Cuban immigration after the revolution. One of them was Celia Cruz. Legend of rumba, guaracha, and guaguancó, the queen of salsa. Celia was born in Havana, trained to be a teacher, but music found her as a singer of the most popular orchestra of Cuba, La Sonora Matancera, where she played for 15 years before moving to America. Celia Cruz took the magic of Cuban rhythms around the world. More than 70 albums, 19 nominations, and winner of 5 Grammys. One star in the Hall of Fame, making her the biggest star of salsa of all time. The fusion of Puerto Ricans with Afro-Cuban artists was extremely important for the future of Latin music in New York. By 1954, Puerto Rican was the largest community in Spanish Harlem, based on the economic connection of America with Puerto Rico, offering multi-talented musicians and singers. One of them is Ismael Rivera, o Maelo.
El guardia escondió la bemba y le dijo...